छाया दुबे, मार्केटिंग मैनेजर, एयर क्रूज एविएशन प्राइवेट लिमिटेड, आई एम अगेन प्रेजेंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू टू डिलीवर अ प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन मेक इन इंडिया इनिशिएटिव एविएशन सेक्टर. इन द लास्ट चैप्टर आई ऑलरेडी मेड द एजेंडा ऑफ मेक इन इंडिया इनिशिएटिव क्लियर, बट लेट अस क्विकली टेक अ रिकैप. So, the mission of Make in India initiative is to facilitate investment, foster innovation, enhance skill development, protect intellectual property, and build best-in-class manufacturing infrastructure in the country. So, why this aviation sector has been chosen as one of the important sectors by Government of India? It is because aviation is one of the most global industries, connecting people, cultures, and business across continents. Aviation provides the only rapid worldwide transportation network, which makes it essential for global business. It generates economic growth, creates jobs, and facilitates international trade and tourism. According to recent estimates by the Cross-Industry Air Transport Action Group, the total economic impact, which includes direct, indirect, induced, and tourism connected, of the global aviation industry reached $2.7 trillion, which estimated to be around 3.5% of world's GDP in 2014. Along with that, the global revenue for commercial airlines in 2019 was estimated at $838 billion. India has 91 international carriers, out of which 5 are domestically owned. India has connectivity with 59 countries through 344 routes. With the industry's $30 billion contributions to India's GDP, the domestic aviation market is projected to rank third globally by 2024. Air traffic has been grown rapidly in the country as compared to the global average. 100 more airports would be developed by 2024 to support Udaan scheme, which stands for Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. It is expected that the air fleet number shall go up to present 600 to 1200 during this time. So now that we are familiar with all the contributions of the aviation industry to the entire economic growth of our country, we can say that if we have world-class manufacturing of aviation industry products, this industry can definitely contribute much more to the Indian economy, and hence government has chosen it as the most important sectors to focus on for Make in India initiative. Now going forward, what we are up to is we need to look for the reasons to invest in this particular sector. If government is asking the companies or the corporates to come forward and invest in Make in India initiative aviation sector, one should have particular reasons to invest in this sector. So the first, here comes the long list of reasons to invest in this sector. So we'll go through it one by one. First of all, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the extension of time and scope for revival and development of underserved and unserved airstrips with $643 million budgetary support, which is itself a huge amount which government is providing. Great focus on infrastructure development such as open sky policy and AAI drive for modernization of airports and air navigation system. Skill India mission has a clear focus to leverage India's human capital potential and create job opportunities. Along with this, it has something to do with innovation and technology as well, where GPS-aided geo-augmented navigation, that is Gagan, is India's first satellite-based augmentation system. It provides additional accuracy for safety in civil aviation and has expansion capabilities for seamless navigation services across geographies. no objection certificate application system streamlines the online process of timely NOC for high clearance of buildings around airports. Along with that, the airport, three AI airports awarded on PPP, three airports vis-a-vis Ahmedabad, Lucknow, and Mangalore of Airports Authority of India have been awarded to private concessionaire through public-private partnership to bring efficiency in delivery, expertise, enterprise, and professionalism apart from harnessing the needed investment in the public sector. That is the action completed. So what government is doing? It is basically having the partnership of the public and the private enterprises to come and and invest in this particular sector. Along with that, the digital initiatives of EGCA has been taken in this sector. So the function and process of Directorate General of Civil Aviation is being moved to an online platform to provide faster delivery of services and regulation oversight. That was initiated on 14th May 2019, and the first module on pilot licensing launched in November 2019. Along with this, the digital initiatives include DigiSky, eSahaj, DigiYatra as well. Now comes Udaan scheme. 34 routes has been operationalized, awarded around one, two, and three tourism RCS. These 34 RCS, which stands for regional transportation system, provides connectivity to four unserved and four underserved airports, connecting 10 served airports under the scheme. This aims to connect the underserved airports or the unserved airports as of now, because what government is up to is providing the airline facility to even the arm nagriks of India. Until now, what the situation is that not everybody in our country is able to afford the the airline services. So what government is up to is that government is providing this airport facility and the airline facilities to the regional cities as well, so that the arm nagrik or the small entrepreneurs working from small cities, they can also take the advantages of this particular scheme. So ICAO to present Council President certificate to India, recognizing India's progress in resolving its safety oversight deficiencies and improving the effective implementation. International Civil Aviation Organization has announced the Council President certificate to India, which would be presented during a special ceremony at ICAO headquarters, Montreal, during the 40th session of the assembly. Robust growth in aviation fleet. Aviation sector has seen a robust growth despite of the grounding of Jet Airways. The number of aircraft has risen for 664 operational aircraft as of 31st August 2019. The EGCA project for development of EGCA application solution is being implemented in four phases. As on date, phase one and phase two services pertaining to pilot licensing, medical examination, and flight training organization have been made live. Services of phase three and four related to other DGCA functions are expected to be completed soon. Now, the recent announcements in this sector. So far, we have seen the reasons to invest in this sector. Now, going forward, we'll see what all recent announcements have been made in this particular sector so as to attract more and more number of companies or the entrepreneurs to come forward and invest in this sector. So first announcement, we'll be going in the descending order for the announcements. Like first, we'll discuss about what is the most recent one, and then going forward, we'll discuss further. The first announcement, that the latest till date, was made on 14th January 2021, where Cabinet Committee on Security cleared a deal worth nearly 48,000 Indian crore rupees for the acquisition of 83 Tejas light combat air aircraft for the Indian Air Force, which was a very big step and a huge milestone for our Indian Air Force. So after that, on 16th November 2020, Ministry of Civil Aviation and Directorate General of Civil Aviation have granted a conditional exemption to the International Crops Research Institute for the semi-arid tropics Hyderabad, Telangana for the deployment of drones for agricultural research activities. So here comes one more addition to the basically the reasons to invest in this particular sector, that this aviation product, that is the drone, drone will now be used for the agricultural research activities as well. So here comes the another opportunity to come forward and invest in this sector. On 6 November 2020, Government of India took the historic decision to implement one rank, one pension. Due to this scheme, 10,795.4 crore has been disbursed to 20,60,220 Defence Forces pensioners, family pensioners. What this policy aims at is that this policy basically does there has been several variations in distributing the pensions to the previous Air Force employees, but under this one rank one pension scheme, the employees will be served with one pension, irrespective of their circumstances in which they have left the services. Now, 16th October 2020, Ministry of Defense organized a webinar on Make in India for the World India-Kazakhstan Defense Cooperation on 15-10-2020 under the aegis of Department of Defense Production through FICCI. What this basically, this webinar aims at is to promote the Make in India initiative for the aviation sector and also to create the awareness among all. So on 9th October 2020, DRDO successfully completed flight test of the indigenously developed anti-radiation missile Rudram. Flight tested today onto a radiation target located on Wheeler Island off the coast of Odisha. Now, after that, we'll talk about the statistics of this particular sector. So the freight traffic on Indian airports is expected to cross 11.4 metric ton by 2022, by which, you know, the transport of the materials or the goods has been done by the Indian airports. And then India is the fastest growing aviation market as per IATA. The country is expected to cater to 520 million passengers by 2037. After that comes the FDI policy, which aims at attracting the foreign companies as well to come forward and invest in India. So for FDI policies, we have two or three different sectors. First one is for the airport, then for the airport transport services, then non-scheduled air transport services, and then the other services. So for airports, 100% FDI is allowed under automatic route for both greenfield as well as for brownfield projects. What these greenfield and brownfield projects are, basically greenfield projects are those projects which aims at in which no work has been done till yet. And brownfield projects are those projects in which some of the work has been done and more need to be done going forward. And then comes the airport transport services. So in this airport transport services, we have two types of services, scheduled air transport services and non-scheduled air transport services. So scheduled air transport services or the domestic scheduled passenger airlines, regional air transport services, in this sector, 49% of FDI is allowed under automatic route, and beyond this, government approval is required. for non-scheduled air transport services and helicopter services, seaplane services, it requires DGCA approval, but 100% FDI is allowed under the automatic route. Now, for the other services under the civil aviation sector, ground handling services, maintenance, repair, and overhaul services, flying institutes, technical training institutions, 100% FDI is allowed under the automatic route. Now comes the sector policy. This aviation sector has some policy. So first one is the Lifeline Udaan. Udaan, which again stands for Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik scheme, was launched to transport experts and equipment to every nook and corner of the country. Under Udaan, work has been initiated to connect 98 unserved and underserved airports, 33 helipads, 12 water aerodromes. Then comes the RCS Udaan. RCS Udaan was launched to promote air connectivity to underserved and unserved and underserved airports in tier 2 and tier 3 cities to stimulate regional growth and provide affordable air travel to the citizens. 76 airport operational till 2014, 53 airports added to the network in the last 6 years. So the total operational airport we have today is close to 129. On 14th January 2021, first flight was flagged off at newly constructed Hisar Airport in Haryana from Chandigarh. And then the first direct flight operations between Nashik, which is in Maharashtra, and Belgaum, which is in Karnataka, also started under the RCS Udaan, which stands for Regional Connectivity Schemes of Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik. Now, here in these two cases, we can see how these small cities of Hisar in Haryana and Nashik in Maharashtra, Belgaum in Karnataka are also being connected by air connectivity. Then comes the NABH Nirman announced in 2018 to 2019 Union Budget, which aims to expand airport capacity by more than 5 times to handle 1 billion trips in a year. The expansion is planned to be funded by leveraging the balance sheet of Airport Authority of India. Secure application for the internet. Indian Army has developed secure application for the internet for a simple and secure messaging application. The application supports an end-to-end secure voice, text, and video calling services for Android platforms over the internet. The application has been vetted by CERT in Impaneled Auditor and Army Cyber Group. India to become a hub for MRO airframe. This is an investment of 2 hangar bays, heavily maintenance facility for narrow bodies aircraft tied up at Kochi Airport by private MRO. Now comes the initiatives for maintenance, repair, and overall services. These are the sector policy which we are discussing. So the maintenance, repair, and overhaul services have to be discussed in the aviation sector. So first of all, the tools and toolkits used by the MRO have been exempted from the custom duty. The exemption shall be based on the list of tools and toolkits certified by the Directorate General of Civil Aviation, approved quality managers of aircraft maintenance organizations. MROs were required to provide proof of their requirements of parts or orders from their client airlines. The process for the clearance of the parts has been brought in line with that of the toolkits for one-time certification by DGCA-approved quality managers in MROs. Restriction of 1 year for utilization of duty-free parts has been extended to 3 years to enable economies of scale to allow the import of unserviceable parts by MROs for providing exchange or advance exchange. The concerned notification has been revised to enable advance export of serviceable parts. Foreign aircraft brought to India for MRO work will be allowed to stay for the entire period of maintenance or up to 6 months. for stay beyond 6 months, DGCS permissions will be required. These are all the sector policies for the aviation sector to attract the entrepreneurs, again, to attract the entrepreneurs to come forward and invest in this particular sector. Now, some financial support has also been provided by various state government and central government for this aviation sector, which are as follows: the MRO for MRO, ground handling, cargo, and aviation turbine fuel infrastructure facilities collocated at an airport, including heliport licensed by DGCA, are covered under the harmonized list of infrastructure in the National Civil Aviation Policy 2016. This makes them eligible to get the benefits offered for the infrastructure sector under the policy. The regional connectivity scheme under the policy provides for following financial support. First, the revival of airstrips and airports as no-frill airport as an indicative cost of $7.1 million to $14.3 million. Demand-driven selection of airport and airstrips for revival in consultation with state government and airlines. Viability gap funding to airline operators, reduced services tax on tickets on 10% of the taxable value for 1 year initially, reduced excise duty at 2% on ATF picked at RCS airport. So this was the financial support provided by government, and these are the various agencies linked with the aviation sector of India: Airport Economic Regulatory Authority of India, Airport Authority of India, Bureau of Civil Aviation Security, Directorate General of Civil Aviation, Ministry of Civil Aviation. So that was it for the presentation. I hope I can convey well about the Make in India initiative of the aviation sector and the various policies and schemes regarding that sector. Thank you very much.